very warm welcome to all you beautiful learners to Unacademy, which is India's largest online learning portal. And today we are going to study this chapter, which is called A Different Type of School. And this is chapter number 5 from your book, Honeysuckle. As you all already know, you can ace your school exams with none other than Unacademy, and you can get the Unacademy subscription at a flat 10% discount if you use my code SWS10. And very, very warm welcome to my class, dear learners. My name is Sweksha and I am your English educator. It is my passion to learn languages, and English is my most favorite, which is how I am here teaching you English today. Alright, so that was a bit about me, and now let's begin with the chapter. And we'll begin with first some words to know. So the first word is bandage, which is a strip of woven material used to bind up a wound or to protect an injured part of your body. So bandage is nothing but that cloth which is tied around a wound. Anytime you get injured or have blood oozing out, then we tie a bandage to protect it. The second word is crutch. A crutch is a long stick with a cross piece at the top, used as a support under the armpit by a person with an injury or a disability. So crutch is nothing but your baisakhi, jisko Hindi mein hum baisakhi bolte hain. Agar kisi ke pair mein koi disability ho, to wo ek stick sa leke ghumta hai na, jo wo arms ke sahare hum chalte hain. So that is your crutch. Okay. Cripple is a severely damaged or malfunctioning. Okay, so cripple is someone who is severely damaged or malfunctioned. Honor, the quality of knowing and doing what is morally right. So if you have honor, then you will do what is morally right. Yani jo acha hai, jo sahi hai, aur jo use karta hai, that person has got honor. Misfortune means bad luck. And system is the way something works, which is a mechanism as well. So the way something works or a mechanism. And now let's begin with the chapter, A Different Kind of School. So do you know these words? If you don't find out their meanings, so we have already done this in the previous slide. It's bandage, crutch, cripple, honor, misfortune and system. So I told you the meanings of all of these words. So when we encounter these words in the chapter, you will not be lost. All right. So a different kind of school. I had heard a great deal about Miss Beam's school, but not till last week did the chance come to visit it. So our author has heard a lot about the school which is opened by Mrs. Beam, okay, but he did not go there ever. He had never been to this school. So last week he got a chance to visit this school, and let's see what he sees there. When I arrived, there was no one in sight but a girl of about 12. Her eyes were covered with a bandage, and she was being led carefully between the flower beds by a little boy who was about 4 years or younger. She stopped and it looked like she asked him who had come. He seemed to be describing me to her, and then they passed on. So when he entered the school, he saw that there was a girl who was about 12 years old, and she was being helped by a little boy. She had a bandage around her eyes, and this little boy stop to tell the description of the author to this girl. Miss Beam was all that I had expected. Middle-aged, full of authority. Authority matlab command. Okay, jaise ki kisi principal, koi school ka principal hota hai, to kya hota hai? Uski authority hoti hai, okay? He can have the authority to command, give commands, okay? And yet kindly and understanding. So this Miss Beam was, she had authority, but still she was kind and understanding as well. So she had two sides of her personality. Her hair was beginning to turn gray, and she had the kind of plump figure that is likely to be comforting to a homesick child. I asked her some questions, and her teaching methods, which I had heard, were simple. So our author, he asked her many questions about her teaching methods and the school, and he had heard that उनके जो पढ़ाने का तरीका है वो काफ़ी सिंपल है. नो मोर देन इज नीडेड टू हेल्प देम टू लर्न हाउ टू डू थिंग्स. सिंपल स्पेलिंग, एडिंग, सब्ट्रैक्टिंग, मल्टीप्लाइंग एंड राइटिंग. द रेस्ट इज डन बाई रीडिंग टू देम एंड बाई इंटरेस्टिंग टॉक्स ड्यूरिंग विच दे हैव टू सिट स्टिल एंड कीप देयर हैंड्स क्वाइट. दे आर प्रैक्टिकली नो अदर लेसन्स. So these are just some simple things that happen at her school. Telling children how to spell, telling children how to add, subtract, and then she used to read out. तो वो उनको काफ़ी interesting बातें बताती थी. Have interesting talks. यानी she used to tell them very interesting things. And the rest is done by practically. And there are no other lessons. The real aim of this school is not to teach thought, as to teach thoughtfulness. So what is the difference between thought and thoughtfulness? Now, thoughts are just ideas, okay? So what are thoughts? Thoughts are just ideas. But thoughtfulness means to think deeply, okay? To think deeply about something, somebody, okay? To have some compassion, okay? That is thoughtfulness. How you think of this world and how do you behave in this world? How do you analyze your own behavior? That is a part of being thoughtful. Kindness to others and being responsible citizens. Look out of the window a minute, will you? So she asked our author to look out of the window. I went to the window which overlooked a large garden and a playground at the back. What do you see? Miss Beam asked. So Miss Beam asked the author to look out of the window, and this window had a beautiful garden and a playground overlooking it, right? Yani window se ye cheezein dikh rahi thi. And the author replied, I see some very beautiful grounds, I said, and a lot of jolly children. It pains me though to see that they are not all so healthy and active looking. When I came in, I saw one poor little girl being led about. She has some trouble with her eyes. Now I can see two more with the same difficulty. And there's a girl with a crutch walking with the others at play. She seems to be a hopeless cripple. So our author described what he was seeing around. So he said that he was seeing many children who were healthy, and then there were some who were not very healthy. There were few who were disabled with their eyes, and a girl was a cripple as well. Now a cripple who was walking on a crutch, as I told you, who is a cripple? Somebody who has got their body part not functioning really well. So using a crutch means probably she had a problem in her leg. So Miss Beam laughed. Oh no, she said, she is not really lame. This is only her lame day. The others are not blind either. It is only their blind day. I must have looked very surprised, for she laughed again. This is a very important part of our system, to make our children appreciate and understand misfortune. We make them share in misfortune too. So what happens? She said that this misfortune that everyone is sharing is not because they are really blind or deaf or dumb, but they are supposed to act like this. They are putting up an act so that they are able to understand the misfortune of other people who do not have their body parts functioning properly. During the blind day, their eyes are bandaged absolutely, and they are on their honor to not to peep. Okay, so what happens? They are on their honor. अभी तो हमने सीखा था कि honor का मतलब क्या है? To do the right thing, which means that it is upon them to not look. It is their own discretion, and they never ever look. The bandage is put on overnight so that they wake up blind, right? So when you wake up blind, then you may have a lot of difficulty and you are only helped around by other children. So other children are given the duty to look after, right? They all learn so much this way. But the blind and the helpers, there is no misery about it. Miss Beam continued. There is no misery about it, Miss Beam continued. Everyone is very kind, and it is really something of a game. So it is just like a game which is played at the school. Before the day was over, even the most thoughtless child realizes that what misfortune is. So this was the way that Miss Beam taught misfortune. Even before the day was over, every child used to understand what is misfortune and how it affects everyone. If one person in your family has this kind of misfortune, then the others have to spend so much time and devotion towards this person. The blind day is of course really the worst, but some of the children tell me that the dumb day is the most difficult. We cannot bandage children's mouths, so they really have to exercise their willpower. Come into the garden and see yourself how the children feel about it. Miss Beam led me to one of the bandaged girls. Here's a gentleman, come to talk to you, said Miss Beam and left us. Do you ever peep? I asked the girl. Oh no, she exclaimed. So our author had gone to meet the girl who had the blind day, and he asked the girl if she ever peeps. So what did the girl reply? Oh no, that would be cheating. But I had no idea it was so awful to be blind. You can't see a thing and you feel you're going to be hit by something every moment. It is such a relief just to sit down. So she said that it is very scary to be blind because har samay aapko ye dar hota hai ki aapko koi na koi aake hit kar dega, and that is really scary, and it is a very big relief just to sit down. Are your helpers kind to you? I asked. Fairly, but they are not as careful as I shall be when it's my turn. Those that have been blind already are the best helpers. It's perfectly ghastly not to see, and I wish you'd try. So ghastly means nothing but scary, okay? And those people, those children who have had their blind day are the best helpers because they know what to do to a blind person. Shall I lead you somewhere? I asked. Oh no, she said. Let's go for a little walk. Only you must tell me about things. I shall be so glad when today is over. The other bad days can't be half as bad as this. So she said that there is no bad day like a blind day, right? The day that you can't see anything is one of the worst days of your life, and she can't wait to get this day to be over. I guess having an arm tied up is a bit more troublesome. Sorry, having a leg tied up is, and hopping on a crutch is almost fun, I guess. Having an arm tied up is a bit more troublesome because you can't eat without help. Things like that. I don't think I'll mind being deaf for a day, at least not much. But being blind is so frightening. My head aches all the time just from worrying that I'll get hurt. Where are we now? So she asks, she says that being blind is very troublesome. Being deaf is not as bad for this girl. Even having a leg not functioning is fun, she says. But your arm tied up, you can't eat, and that is not fun for this girl. In the playground, I said, we are walking towards the house. Miss Beam is walking up and down the garden with a tall girl. What is the girl wearing? My little friend asked. A blue cotton skirt and a pink blouse. I think it's Miller, she said. What color is her hair? Very light, I said. Yes, that's Millie. She is the head girl. There is an old man tying up roses, I said. Yes, that's Peter. He is the gardener, and he's hundreds of years old. This is just a joke. that Gardner must be very, very old, and that is why she said that he's hundreds of years old. And here comes a girl with curly red hair. She's on crutches. Okay, so there was another girl with curly red hair and who had crutches. That's Anita, she said. And so we walked on. Gradually, I discovered that I was 10 times more thoughtful than I ever thought I could be. I also realized that I had to describe people and things to someone else. It made them more interesting to me. When I finally had to leave, I told Miss Beam that I was very sorry to go. Ah, she replied, then there is something in my system after all. So this is a story which is simplified by Evie Lucas. So in this story, we see that Miss Beam has a school where the children have to pretend, okay, for a day they have to pretend to be someone with a disability. And our author finds out how difficult it can be to live like that. Also, think about this in this way, that there are other children who are helping. Now, they are able to learn kindness and how to help others while they are helping these other children who are pretending to be crippled or blind. So, this is a great system of schooling which was discovered by Miss Beam. Now, let's look at the question answers. The first one is something that you can do on your own. It's just a bit of a text that you have to match from your book, but we will definitely do the question answers. So, why do you think writer visited Miss Beam's school? So, writer visited Miss Beam's school because our writer had heard a lot about this school and he had wanted to visit this school from a long, long time, and last week he got a chance to visit the school. What was the game that every child in the school had to play? So we just learned about the game that every child had to play. They had to pretend, okay? They had to do a role play, okay? And this role play was that of being a cripple or being blind or being deaf for a day, and they were being helped by their other class members. So this was the game. Each term, every child has one blind day, one lame day. Complete the line. Which day was the hardest and why was it the hardest? So one blind day, one lame day, and one deaf day and a dumb day. As per the opinion of the girl, the blind day was the toughest because you were always scared that you'll be hit by something or someone. What was the purpose of these special days? So as we know, dear children, that the purpose of these special days was just to teach about misfortune, okay, to other children, okay? She wanted her to understand how does it feel to not have one of your body parts working. It makes you more thankful to God as well. Now let's look at the meanings of these words and then we can quickly match them. So the number one, word number one is homesick, and that means, let's just look at the box, wanting to be home. Homesick means wanting to be home. So you can tick that or write number one against wanting to be home. Practically, let's understand what is the meaning of practically from this. I think practically here would mean understanding the difficulties. It pains me would mean that it hurts me. So you can put a number three against it, hurts me. To appreciate means appreciate could mean a welcome change over here, number four, okay? Thoughtless could be not very caring, number five could be not very caring, okay? Exercise would be a test of strength. Okay, so number six you can put as test of strength. Relief relief could be a welcome change. A welcome change could be relief here as well. Ghastly. Ghastly would mean terrible. Okay. Ghastly would mean terrible. And just a second. So appreciate could be just a second. Let's look at number 9. It is very changed to make our children appreciate and understand misfortune. Okay, so here appreciate could mean understand the difficulty. Okay, to appreciate here could mean to understand the difficulty as per our chapter. Otherwise, appreciate means to like something. So that brings us to the end of this chapter, and you can always go for the Unacademy's Plus subscription. The features are mentioned on the screen. You can learn live from the comfort of your home. There are unlimited access to all the courses. Top educators of India can be found on this one platform. There's regular doubt clearing and answer writing sessions, exhaustive coverage of the entire syllabus, mentorship and guidance is also available. Study material is available in PDF format, practice tests, live test series and batch courses are available. The pricing of the Plus subscription is here on the screen, and you can always use my code SWS10 to get a flat 10% discount. Also, Unacademy's iconic subscription features are on the screen. You get personal mentorship, you get live doubt solving, weekly report, Parents Connect, study planner, and all the benefits of the Unacademy Plus subscription. The pricing is on the screen for the Unacademy iconic, and you can use my code SWS10 to get a flat 10% discount. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. I really hope that you are able to revise this chapter with the help of this video. Do like, share and subscribe to our video and to this channel. Also do hit the bell icon so that you never ever miss a class from us. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll be back with another chapter. See you all. Bye bye.